if it's T, then the important parameter is minus dt square plus dx square. And the reasonable patch is minus rho square to theta square plus the rho square. Okay? And if this is the rho equal to the constant, and this is the theta equal to constant, and here is theta equal to minus infinity, and here is theta equal to plus. Okay? So the space time is Fourier effective. Okay? And then we go to Kleene signature. And the Minkowski, of course, is just T goes to minus ITE, like for the decreasing time. So the Winkler, I will do minus I theta. Okay? It's minus 54. So, the Minkowski signature, the Minkowski, standard Minkowski just becomes E squared plus the X squared. And this reason is just rho square, the theta square plus the rho square. In particular, this theta identifies the scale 2 pi, the increasing analytic configuration, of Minkowski, and the interval are actually identical. And then the full Euclidean two-dimensional Euclidean space. Okay? So if you do the standard Minkowski, you just replace x by te. But for the reasoner, you just replace it by rho theta. Okay? By rho theta. But you just run into different variation, and this will run into the polar coordinate, this will run into the Cartesian coordinate. So the remarkable thing is that even in the Lorentz signature, the reasoner is only part of the Minkowski space time. Okay, but once you go to Euclidean, if you do this identification of theta plus 2 pi, you have exactly the same Euclidean manifold. Okay, so it's identical. So this immediately means one thing. It's an early Euclidean observable. So the Euclidean coordinate transformation from the Cartesian to the polar coordinate, all the Euclidean observables are identical. Yeah, this means that you're creating two-dimensional space time. It's Q. So this is just a two-dimensional creating space. Yeah. Okay? So from here, we immediately the conclusion we said earlier, because of Minkowski, so you consider the equation collision function, and then you analyze it back to the Lorentz signature, what you get is that you get the collision function in the Minkowski vacuum, in the standard Minkowski vacuum, okay? So for Minkowski, analyze it back to the Lorentz. So the typical observable for equation collision functions, that goes to collision functions in the standard Minkowski vacuum, okay? This is a trivial PFT in your high school. But with this top statement, we make a very logical conclusion. It's a polynomial.